I'm Dr. Ros Taylor. I'm medical director at Harlington and Michael Sobell Hospice, and I know some of you, and I hope you'll forgive me if I don't remember all of your names. And we are here this afternoon to celebrate many lives lost. And I have a few thoughts about memories which I would like to share with you. Remembering is hard, it's hard work, and we have to work at it. And ceremonies like this really help, I feel. So I used to read the story of Flat Stanley to my children. Some of you may know it. My children loved the story, and I was thinking about what it might mean for us today. Yes. So Stanley wakes up one morning, and he's become completely invisible. His shocked parents run into his bedroom to see a shape of Stanley in his bed, an outline of Stanley, but no visible Stanley. So I want to talk about this outline, the imprint of an invisible person. Often, after a death, I'm struck by this imprint of a life. I speak with families often, and I feel I can make out this outline of a life lived through stories, through memories, through jokes. And today, the imprint of the lives you are remembering today remains. That imprint remains just like the imprint Stanley left on his bed. So our loved ones leave outlines which linger and provide us with a connection to what once was, like a shadow we might chase. So perhaps we're here this afternoon as shadow chasers, trying to hold on to lives we have loved and lost. I know that my life continues to be influenced by those I have loved and lost. But holding on to shadows is hard. We have to sift through a person's life to look for ways we can live, look for ways that we can live that special life forward, our special life. We have to work hard to remember, as I said, to remember the gifts that have been left to us, the gifts of humour, the gifts of stories, the gifts of recipes, the gifts of parties, the gifts of time together. And tonight is an opportunity to really remember and recognise those gifts that we've all been left, to enjoy them and let them heal our grief. And then I wonder sometimes about the imprint we might leave behind when our own time comes, and I know that's a difficult thought. So perhaps we're also here as shadow makers as well as shadow chasers, shaping the outline, casting a shape that will last well beyond our own lives. And can we live in such a way that something lingers after us? I do believe that we all have opportunities to cast ripples beyond the reach of our own lives, and you're all doing this by being here today. We make ripples not only through grand achievements, but also through everyday tiny actions of kindness. So we can cast an imprint by living our lives thoughtfully, and not just as individuals. Communities also leave imprints for the future, and as a community, you are leaving a very special imprint today by supporting the hospice and being with us. Just this week, the hospice helped a family make a lasting imprint. Two of our heroic nurses took a dying mum, her husband, and a five-year-old on a very brave trip to Euro Disney on Wednesday. It had been on the mum's bucket list for a long time, but illness and COVID stopped it from happening. It was a perfect day, amazing memories created. Tragically, the young mum died yesterday, but the memories created on Wednesday are a special gift for her family forever. So this afternoon, we are lighting up those lives who have left an imprint for us. And you have helped us with your donations to create imprints for other families, just like the Euro Disney story, I hope. So I'd like to wish you all peaceful times ahead, and I hope you find this ceremony uplifting and healing. Thank you.
Last night he came to see me when the darkness had no light. You stepped into my room and I felt your spirit bright. You taught me that you were happy and removed of earthly pain. You said I must believe that our paths would cross again. You taught me that you were proud of the life I carry on. You taught me that you were close, that I would never be alone. Last night when you came to see me, and when the morning came around, I knew I wasn't dreaming by your feather on the ground.
Thank you. unknown. Don't remember me with sadness. Don't remember me with tears. Remember all the laughter we shared throughout the years. Now I am contented that my life, it was worthwhile, knowing as I passed along the way, I made somebody smile. When you are walking down the street and you've got me on your mind, I'm walking in your footsteps, only half a step behind. So please don't be unhappy just because I'm out of sight. Remember that I'm with you each morning, noon and night.
Take the Love by Donna Ashworth. Take the love you had for me and turn it into laughter. Turn it into blinding light to shine on you thereafter. Take the love you have for me and show it to the world. Something so amazing needs to blossom and unfurl. Take the love that made us, keep it burning bright. Let that fire guide you, let it warm you through the night. Take the love you shared with me and spread it out with gladness. My life will not have been in vain if you can fight the sadness. Take the love, my darling, it's yours to carry on. Grow that love forevermore and then I won't be gone.
Hawkins. You can shed tears that they are gone, or you can smile because they have lived. You can close your eyes and pray they'll come back, or you can open your eyes and see all they've left. Your heart can be empty because you can't see them, or you can be full of the love you shared. You can turn your back on tomorrow and live yesterday, or you can be happy for tomorrow because of yesterday. You can remember them only that they are gone, or you can cherish their memory and let it live on. You can cry and close your mind, be empty and turn your back, or you can do what they'd want. Smile, open your eyes, love, and go on.
Miss me, but let me go. When I come to the end of the road and the sun has set for me, I want no rights in a gloom-filled room. Why cry for a soul set free? Miss me a little, but not for long, and not with your head bowed low. Remember the love that once we shared. Miss me, but let me go. For this is a journey we all must take, and each must go alone. It's all part of the master plan, a step on the road to home. When you are lonely and sick at heart, go to the friends we know. Laugh at all the things we used to do. Miss me, but let me go. Right, it's come to the time in the ceremony that we are going to have the lighting of the lights. Now, hopefully you should all have a little tea light on your chair. If you haven't, put your hand up and someone will bring one round to you. There's a plastic bit at the bottom, if you can remove that and then turn the lights on. And then what we're going to do is going to dim the lights, and the lights will come on the outside to my left and to your right. So if you take, the lights will go down now.
Thank you.
don't know me, my name is Carol Weston and I'm the matron at Harlington and Michael Sobell Hospice. I just wanted to say a big thank you to each and every one of you for coming this evening, and I hope you've all enjoyed the ceremony. I want to say a big thank you to all of the readers, and especially to Ros Taylor for her opening to the ceremony. Also, a big thank you to the fundraising team who put this event on, so thank you. When we're finished, if you'd like to stay behind and have a cup of tea and a mince pie, that would be lovely. We also have got some Christmas cards that we're selling just outside the hall here, if anyone wants to. I'd like to say a huge big thank you to Lemon Tuesday. I'm sure you will agree, they've been absolutely fantastic, as they have been every year that they've done the ceremonies with us. We're very grateful to have you, so thank you very much. Now, Lemon Cheese have been coming for how many years? I couldn't quite remember, but yeah, probably was. And one of the songs they did one year is absolutely beautiful. And it wasn't on today's service, but we've decided we're going to tag it on to the end for you all. It's my personal favourite. The song is called So Good, and it's from the musical Wicked. The words in it are absolutely gorgeous. The first time that you sang it here, I went over to the hospice, to the inpatient unit, and spoke to my colleagues that were working that day, and said how lovely that song was, how really fitting it was for this ceremony. And my Christmas present that year from the girls was those words in a frame, and they're in my office, so I see them every day. So thank you very much, Lemon Tuesday. And we've got one last number, so thank you.